Do you think the Russians have something on Donald Trump?
I think it's possible. I don't know. These are more words I never thought I'd utter about a president of the United States, but it's possible.
That's stunning. You can't say for certain that the president of the United States is not compromised by the Russians.
Yeah, it is stunning, and I wish I wasn't saying it, but it's just, it's the truth.
All right, fired FBI Director James Comey suggesting the Russians may have blackmail on President Trump. The RNC and the allies of the president are going after Comey's credibility in a coordinated way. Here to discuss that and more is Ronna McDaniel. She is the chairwoman of the Republican National Committee. Ronna, good morning.
Good morning, Allison.
So what is the plan this morning to discredit James Comey?
Well, we just want to remind the American public of James Comey, the things that had happened during the 2016 election, him inserting himself, some of the testimony he gave that he hadn't leaked when in fact he had to a friend to give information to the press. We just want to put a counter narrative out there because we know that he's putting his opinions out, his version of the truth, and I think it's important to push back.
We have, an email, an image that you've sent out in an email to, I guess, supporters, and it says here, James and the Giant Breach, obviously a play on James and the Giant Peach. That's an awfully playful take on some of this. I mean, what are you hoping to accomplish with an email like that?
Well, it's important to point out James Comey's record. I mean, he's discredited himself. I think you've discussed that today extensively on your show. The fact that he inserted himself into this election, that he broke FBI longstanding protocol, that now he is writing a tell-all book for millions of dollars. I think it speaks for itself, and it's important to take this as one man's opinion, one man's version. The president pushes back on a lot of the things that James Comey asserts, and we're here to put that narrative out there because he's going to be doing his media rounds and getting his attention and trying to sell his book, and it's important that the American people see both sides.
So are you concerned that the former head of America's law enforcement agency does say things like that he thinks that President Trump is morally unfit to lead the country, that he does talk about how President Trump did ask him for a loyalty oath? What most worries you?
I think James Comey put his opinion out. I think millions of Americans who voted for President Trump would disagree. When you see our economy humming, when you see record unemployment across Hispanic, African-American communities, women, it's at an 18-year low. When you see the decisive actions he took with Syria over the weekend to put Assad in his place, to call him the monster that he is, to push back on chemical weapons, when you see him strengthening our military, taking care of our veterans. I mean, the actions of this president show that he is a moral leader because he is working for the American people and pushing back on monsters like Bashar al-Assad.
Do you think it's possible that by going after James Comey and talking about him, that you're actually helping him sell books?
Well, I think he has his media rounds. You know, he's going to be on CNN this week, as you've advertised. He had the big interview with George Stephanopoulos. It's part of our job to push back, and he's going to sell his books. Look at the salacious details he's put in these excerpts that have been released. I mean, this is somebody who wants a payday. He has taken his private conversations with the president and monetized them. I think that is something that's discrediting. And we're going to push back. I think that's important for the American people to see both sides and remember who James Comey is. I mean, Democrats and Republicans have called out James Comey. It's the one thing we've had bipartisan agreement on in the past year and a half. And if you go to the website that we've put forward, all of the criticism on there is from Democrats. Chuck Schumer, Nancy Pelosi, Howard Dean, Tim Kaine, Hillary Clinton's running mate. I mean, this is somebody who really lost the confidence of our country as FBI director.
And yet, I mean, as you know, the latest polling shows that more Americans trust James Comey. This is the ABC News poll. This was taken before the interview than they do President Trump, 48% to 32%.
Yeah, I don't think most Americans have paid attention to James Comey, and that's part of the reason why we have done this campaign. I think you've heard Loretta Lynch come out and say that James Comey is misrepresenting, that he broke traditions of DOJ protocol. You've seen Lanny Davis write his op-ed saying that James Comey is a liar with the way he handled the Clinton investigation and the reasons why he reopened that and disclosed that to the public. I mean, this is something that's coming from across all corners. And I don't think the American people have dialed in. Obviously, the president, somebody who's well-known, he gets a lot of media coverage. Not all of it's positive. And James Comey is somebody who's relatively unknown.
Are you more worried at the RNC about James Comey or Michael Cohen?
You know, I'm worried about the midterm elections. I want to make sure we keep this comeback for this country. Our country has turned around under President Trump. I saw it in Michigan. People who had lost hope, who felt like they were stuck, whose wages had stagnated for a decade. Now they're now seeing their wages go up, their paychecks are bigger, jobs are coming back to this country, manufacturing is coming back to this country. I want to make sure we keep majorities that are going to continue to work with this president and keep this comeback alive. That's what I think about every day. That's my focus as RNC chair, is these midterm elections.
Rana, I've got to ask you about what's been going on at the RNC with your finance committee. So Michael Cohen, as you know, who's now being investigated by the FBI in terms of his payments to this porn star, Stormy Daniels, Steve Wynn, obviously, who was an important official at the RNC in terms of fundraising, he's being investigated. He lost his position because of so many sexual harassment claims against him. And then this guy, Elliot Brody, who impregnated a Playboy model while he was married and arranged this $1.6 million to try to keep that quiet. What does this all say about the culture at the RNC?
Well, I think you're calling out three cases. Elliot and Steve resigned. Obviously, the charges were troubling. We made sure to take swift action. I mean, we have hundreds of fundraisers, 500,000 small online donors for this president. We are focused on the midterm elections. I am the key fundraiser, along with the president and our finance chairman, Todd Ricketts. We're out there every day keeping our eyes on these midterms. Nothing's going to distract us from our mission of keeping majorities.
Yeah, but I mean, I'm just talking about in this Me Too moment, what does it say that your finance committee is embroiled in this?
This is something that's across party lines. You have Democrats who've had this issue. You have Republicans across, who've had this issue. We need to make sure that we take swift action, which we did with Steve Wynn and Elliot Brody, who resigned. I'm sure Democrats have fundraisers out there who've had similar issues.
Sure, but you know, this is the moment
on the American people. Yeah, but you know what, Allison, come on. It's across party lines. Look at that. This isn't just a Republican issue. The Me Too moment is affecting Republicans and Democrats.
For sure.
And we need to address it.
I mean, look at Harvey Weinstein, but I'm just saying, is there something about the culture?
From a finance standpoint, the number one fundraiser for the RNC is me. I'm out there every day raising money for these midterms. Nothing is distracting me from my mission because I look at how far our country has come under Trump's leadership. I look at people in my state who are seeing jobs coming back, home prices going up, our military being funded, our veterans taken care of. That's what I think about every day. This is just a distraction. I think Main Street America is more focused on, is my paycheck bigger? Am I going to have a job next week? How's my family doing? That's what they're thinking about.
Is Michael Cohen still a part of the Finance Committee?
Michael Cohen has not been charged with anything. He's under investigation. I believe in due process. I'm sure you do, too. So we'll see what happens.
But right now he is. So he is still part of the finance.
He's distracted. He's focusing on some other things. I'm out there fundraising every day to keep our majorities, put resources on the ground. We had a National Day of Action this weekend. We had volunteers across this country. We are in the best position we have ever been as a party going into a midterm. We've raised double the DNC. We've made more voter contacts.
Yeah.
We've recruited more volunteers.
I hear you.
That's what I think about every day.
I get it. I understand. So, but you're saying that at this moment, he is still part of that finance committee.
He is.
Okay. Rana McDaniel, thank you very much. Appreciate you weighing in on all.